In 1972, American soul-funk powerhouse Earth, Wind & Fire released their third album, Last Days in Time, and from it, the cosmic soul-funk instrumental, Power. Their trademark kalimba. I love its echo, bit of an echo effect. I love that sound. It's kind of like a xylophone in a way. Well, very different, but kind of has a similar tone. Almost sounds like they're playing two at the same time. God, the few bands made as much use of this instrument as Earth, Wind, and Fire. They even titled a song Kalimba. Okay, hear that clavinet interacting with that really scratchy guitar? It just kind of... Okay, we've got, in my left speaker, we've got some really prominent tambourine, got the really scratchy guitar coming from my right speaker. The clavinet is just kind of subtle, kind of like low in the mix, but it's there. It's kind of like circling around those guitar chords. And that kalimba is just glowing right over everything, just little glow notes. A7 minor. Minor. Okay, we have a change of cadence here, more kind of like flowing now. We've got that bass line guiding us now. Yeah, it's like for, it took more than 2 minutes for the bass to come in. Okay, that saxophone has supplanted everything else as my favorite element of the track. Oh, I love the billowing, just clean, pure tone of that. Played by Ronnie Laws, yeah, of the Laws clan, yeah, the very musical Laws brood, yeah. (Laughs) only album by Earth, Wind, and Fire to feature Ronnie Laws as a member. Yeah, I was thinking to myself, yeah, I hadn't quite heard a sax solo quite like this on any other Earth, Wind, and Fire albums. This is early on in his career. I think he's the last born, I think. No, Deborah, I think, is the last born. But the Deborah and him are considerably younger than the other two, though, Hubert and Eloise. This is right after this is early in his career, too. He had just, he was fresh off a stint with Hugh Masakela, yeah. The South African expat who, was mostly stateside based, but yeah, did a stint with him early, like at the start of the 1970s, and then joined this band, and then beyond that went and launched his solo career. Scratchy guitar that we're hearing is by Roland Bautista, who joined for this album and then left right afterwards, but rejoined the band 9 years later and played on their early 80s trilogy, Rays, Power Light, and Electric Universe. Yeah, and in 1977 he put out a solo album, pretty good, would also during the 1970s play with the Crusaders, and would play with Ronnie Laws on some of on the Pressure Sensitive album. Okay, that bass is by Verdine White, who was the longtime player in the band. He was a... And some of the percussions here are played by Philip Bailey. This is his first album with the band, and he was pretty young when he joined. F sharp minor. Oh, I love that sizzling tone right there. Okay, we've got that persistent beat, we've got the bass line, and then we've got that just sizzling, fuzzy guitar just, putting a line of fire over it all. And then we've got some, low in the mix, we've got that, like, clavinet. Now, maybe it's not a clavinet, maybe it's just kind of like maybe there's kind of like a wah on a electric piano or something. It's so faint though. Yeah, I haven't heard guitar solos like this on any other album. In fact, this track, because this is the only instrumental workout on this album, and yeah. This track is in. They did quite a few like lengthy instrumentals during the early 1970s, up through like 1974 anyway, like their first five albums. But this is in a class of its own just because of who's playing on it. Yeah. Flute salad, yeah, just flute billowing, kind of like smoke, like fog, like, and then with that electric piano, I love that effect, kind of like psychedelic flute salad, yeah. Two flutes, or three. Ronnie Laws apparently multi-tracked, because he's the only person credited on flute. Yeah. Okay, that's definitely a clavinet. That kalimba kind of reassuring itself a bit in the background, glowing. Yeah, the kalimba, we got the kalimba, the clavinet, the crafty bass line, and the scratchy scratch, kind of now somewhat lower in the mix now. Now it's just kind of like everyone all together now. Maurice White, who composed the track, plays the kalimba. Yeah, that was Earth, Wind, and Fire with Power from their 1972 release, Last Day in Time. Yeah, and the song just had that beautiful, glowy, tinkly tone, bookending it, basically. And then this great, funky workout with that scratchy guitar and crafty bass line. And then ultimately, two just really standout solos from two of the finest players that they ever had in their lineup. Sadly, all too brief, yeah. Roland Bautista, the guitarist, and Ronnie Laws, the reedist. Yeah, and just creating a kind of magic that stands out, is an island unto itself in the many magical moments of Earth, Wind, and Fire between like 1971 and 1983 anyway. Yeah. For more Rubies and Sapphires from the catalog of Earth, Wind, and Fire, see the directory of albums by American funk artists linked in the description below for Red Hot Tracks and Purples from all the Earth, Wind, and Fire albums from the years that I just mentioned, as well as many other funk acts of the period. And over 500 albums strong. And then go to its sibling directory, the directory of albums by American jazz funk artists, where you can find albums by Ronnie Laws and Roland Bautista and many other great soloists who kind of were kind of at that crossroads between funk and jazz during the 1970s and 80s. Yes. Like and subscribe, follow me on social media and share the video, and leave a comment if there are any observations you have that you'd like to share about the track we just heard, the layers, the nuances, the interplay, the counterpoint, the soloing, the instrumentation, the arrangements. Yeah, who do you think had the best solo? What was the most, what was the standout moment to you? Yeah. And until next time, this is Zaragon, the world's most ear-traveled Tremex, most same note.